of the first things I fell in love with when I came here in 1999 was the water. The emerald waters of the Gulf of Mexico, sailing in Pensacola Bay, the way the drive home was enhanced by a detour up scenic highway to see the sun bounce off Escambia Bay. Most of all, I love the bayous and the stories people told about them. The stories of fishing and swimming, water skiing and dolphin spotting helped me learn how deeply woven into the fabric of life the water is here. Those stories made me sad too, because nearly everyone who told me one of those stories told me they couldn't really do that stuff anymore. Years of pollution and neglect, purposeful and benign, had degraded the water quality in those bodies so that the fun people had in them was mostly a memory. Slowly, that has changed. The city passed a stormwater ordinance that creates a funding stream to battle the main culprit of pollution, runoff. Two things are clear from the data about water quality tests on the Pensacola Bay system between 2003 and 2013. It is improving, and it still has a long way to go. In 2003, 42% of the water quality tests done exceeded the federal guidelines for safety. 10 years later, 29% of those tests exceeded the federal guidelines. But a little better than 1 in 3 is not really the ratio that's good enough. Not for a community like this one, which lives and dies by the water. The coast is what draws people here, enchants them, and makes them want to return. It is the way many of us make a living, and it's what makes living here special to all of us. The proposed Fishery Enhancement Center at Bruce Beach was one of the first big projects to be funded in Florida with BP money. Money intended to make amends for the environmental damage the 2010 spill caused. In 2011, the City Council unanimously approved entering into negotiations for the project, and just a few weeks ago, the $19 million officially came through. In the meantime, questions have arisen about the project. Is a lease of $1 a year too little for such a valuable piece of downtown real estate? Surely we could sell it for more money than that, to that long line of developers who are beating down the door to buy those vacant parcels at the Community Maritime Park and the Main Street Sewer Plant site, and the Pensacola Technology Campus, and the old Blunt School site, and the Vernon McDaniel Building on Garden Street, and well, you get the picture. Are the 12 or so jobs the facility is projected to create enough to justify the deal? Is the research and education aspect of the proposal an enhancement to the mission or an add-on at the late hour to make it more palatable as an environmental project? Is the habitat of Pensacola Bay healthy enough to sustain these hatchery fish, which have a mixed legacy once they're introduced into the wild? At a recent press conference, City Administrator Colleen Castile elaborated on the project, noting that seagrasses will be grown at the center and adding to the habitat restoration effort. Mayor Ashton Hayward touted it as a way to bring research into the fold as a feature of our waterfront. I love that these questions are being asked because it shows we care. It shows that after decades of taking whatever industry we could get, no matter the impact on the environment or our quality of life, we want to think critically about what will become of our coastline. It shows that after the investment we put into our living shoreline efforts and Project Green Shores, we want to think carefully about expanding that spirit west along the shoreline. The questions show we recognize the valuable asset that is our coastline and that we don't want to repeat the sins of the ecological past. Thanks again for joining us. You can take part in the conversation at progresspromise.com, on our Facebook page, and Our Progress Now on Twitter. We'll see you next time.